فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. Within the explanation of the third book of this Dawra, which we named it Dabdul Ilm, Precision in Knowledge. We previously finished the explanation of the Kitab Al-Qawa'id Al-Arba' written by the author himself, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. And we also finished the explanation of the Kitab Nukhbatul Fikr fi Mustalah Ahli Al-Athar written by Hafiz ibn Hajar Al-Asqalani. Yesterday we read half of, I'm a part of, this Kitab Thalaathatul Usool. And inshaAllah ta'ala today we're going to finish it all. Bi'idhnillahi al-Kareem. سم.
الأصل الأول فإذا قيل لك من ربك فقل رضي الله الذي رباني رب جميع العالمين بنعمه وهو معبودي ليس لي معبود سواه والدليل قوله تعالى أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وكل ما سوى الله عالم وأنا واحد من ذلك العالم فإذا قيل لك بما عرفت ربك فقل بآياته ومخلوقاته ومن آياته الليل والنهار والشمس والقمر ومن مخلوقاته السماوات السبع ومن فيهن والأرضون السبع ومن فيهن وما بينهما والدليل قوله تعالى ومن آياته الليل والنهار والشمس والقمر لا تسجدوا للشمس ولا للقمر واسجدوا لله الذي خلقهن إن كنتم إياه تعبدون وقوله تعالى إن ربكم الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام ثم استوى على العرش يغشى الليل النهار يطلبه حثيثا والشمس والقمر والنجوم مسخرات بأمره ألا له الخلق والأمر
The author, rahimahullah ta'ala, carry on.
والرب هو المعبود والدليل قوله تعالى يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون الذي جعل لكم الأرض فراشا والسماء بناء وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا وأنتم تعلمون قال ابن كثير رحمه الله تعالى الخالق لهذه الأشياء هو المستحق للعبادة.
The author رحمه الله, he started to clarify the first foundation from the three foundation in which he authored this book for. The first foundation, and that is Ma'rifatul Abdi Rabbahu, the slave knowing his Lord. And the author said, فَإِذَا قِيلَ لَكَ, if it is said to you, مَنْ رَبُّكَ, who is your Lord? فَقُلْ, respond by saying, رَبِّيَ اللَّهُ, my Lord is Allah. الَّذِي رَبَّانِي, the one who cultivated me. وَرَبَّى جَمِيعَ الْعَالَمِينَ بِنِعْمَتِهِ, and he is the one who cultivated the whole world, universe, with his blessing, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the word الرَّبُّ is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from Allah's rububiyyah is تَرْبِيَةُ الْخَلْقِ, Allah nurturing the creation with his blessings, the external blessings and the internal blessings that Allah gives to each and every one of us. Allah gives us external benefits and blessings by giving us children and giving us health. And the internal blessing is Allah giving us Islam as a religion. And Islam is a blessing. As Allah said in the Quran, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. اليوم, today I have completed your religion unto you. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي, and I have completed my blessing unto you. ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا, and I have become pleased with Islam as a religion for you. So this is the internal blessings that Allah gives a person. After bringing a person into Islam, after coming into Islam, there's another blessing within Islam that not many people get. And that is the blessing of As-Sunnah, Ni'mat As-Sunnah, which is another blessing within Islam. Because a lot of people are blessed by being allowed to be Muslims, but they are not blessed enough to be from the people of the Sunnah, who are holding onto the right path within Islam. Because as you all know, Islam has many deviated groups within it. Within the Muslims today, there are many deviated groups. And there's only one group who are saved, as the Messenger told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, to be guided and to be blessed enough to be from that group is an extra blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِذَلِكَ the salaf of هَذِي الْأُمَّةِ, they used to say, I don't know. Which of the two blessings should I be most happy with? And هَدَانِ اللَّهُ إِلَى الْإِسْلَامِ, and هَدَانِ اللَّهُ إِلَى الْإِسْلَامِ, that Allah guided me to Islam, or that Allah guided me to the Sunnah. The ni'mah, what they're trying to say from here is, is as much as you might see that coming into Islam and being a Muslim is a blessing, being from the people of the Sunnah is also an extra and an additional blessing. Some of the Salaf, they used to say, you have to thank Allah extra from being guided to be from the people of the Sunnah. So you have to feel this blessing, just like you have to feel the blessing of Al-Islam. It's no different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who nurtured you. Right now that you're sitting here, you're breathing, your body is functioning, your brain is working, your eyes are looking, and everything that Allah gave this to you subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is blessings. He is the one who then deserves to be worshipped. Why are you going to worship a person who has nothing to do with your affairs, who can't run your affairs? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forsaked you, طَرْفَةَ عَيْنِ, split second, He left you. Not to other people, but to your own self, you'll be destroyed. Even you can't run your own affairs. You'll be confused and you'll be mind boggled, baffled, you don't know. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet's dua used to be, وَلَا تَكِلْنِي إِلَى نَفْسِي طَرْفَةَ عَيْنِ. Don't pass my own affairs to me, before anybody else. Don't give it to me. Even a split second, don't give it to me. I can't run my own affairs. And then the one who runs your affairs like that, who controls everything about you. Look at people who get sick and ill and they go to hospital. The doctors try to solve a problem, a complication that's happened. They're just trying their best. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all He has to say is, kun bi, fayakun, it will become. And then that's the one who deserves to be worshipped. No one else. That's the one you need to be connected to. No one else. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not one that you run to when you only feel pain and suffering and hardship. At times of ease and joy, you remember Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is coming with ash-shukr. Ibn al-Qayyim mentions five things that if a person comes with, the true essence of what shukr is. He mentions it in his kitab, Iddatu Sabirin wa Dakhiratu Shakirin. I advise you guys to go and look for it yourselves. Five things is what shukr is. If you don't come with these five, you haven't come with shukr. And you are not upon the path of shukr. Five, usool, shukr goes back to. He mentions that in his kitab, Iddatu Sabirin wa Dakhiratu Shakirin. Because many people ask, how can I express gratitude to Allah? How? The author here only mentions, and he puts forward to you, one of the five that the author, Ibn al-Qayyim, mentions, which is istish'ar, feeling, and recognizing that Allah blessed you. If you're in a state of denial that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you this, how are you going to show gratitude? One of the five Ibn al-Qayyim mentions what? Is the thing Allah blessed you with, don't use it in that which is in disobedience of His. If you want to show Allah gratitude, the eyes that He gave you, you want to show gratitude to Him in these eyes that He's given you, don't use it for that which He prohibited you from, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the ears that He gave you, don't use it for that which He prohibited, subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you use your eyes for that which is in disobedience to His command, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your ears, then you're not showing Him gratitude. And you're not a shakir. And that's what the author says, وَهُوَ مَعْبُودِي. And so because of that, he's the one who I worship. لَيْسَ لِي مَعْبُودٌ سِوَاهُ. There is no one besides Him that I worship, the author said. And then the author mentions the evidence for رُبُوبِيَّ and أُلُوهِيَّ. رُبُوبِيَّ is in قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى أَلْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ is رُبُوبِيَّ. And أُلُوهِيَّ is what? أَلْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. Alhamdulillah means Alhamdu, praise. Ka'inul lahu, it is for Him, Allah. لِأَنَّهُ الْمَأْلُوهُ الْمُسْتَحِقُ لِلْعِبَادَةِ. Because He is the one who is worshipped, the one who is taken as an ilah, the one who deserves to be worshipped. He is praiseworthy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, it is obligated on each and every one of us to know Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. But there's an amount that's needed. Knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a very general and generic statement. Knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a scholar knows Allah, and an army knows Allah. But is their knowledge of Allah both the same? No, it's not. The fundamental, write this down, is very important. Usool. Ma'rifatullahi al-wajiba, the amount that is obligatory on everybody to know Allah about, is four things. These four things are the amount that is obligatory on everybody. If you increase on that, your connection and your bond with Allah becomes more. But this amount is obligatory on everybody. You have no excuse to be ignorant of Allah this amount. The first one is ma'rifatu, knowing wujudihi, Allah's existence. You have to know Allah exists, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you believe, fayu'minu, the person believes, al-'abdu bi'annahu mawjudun, Allah exists. You believe Allah exists. The first one is ma'rifatu wujudihi, knowing Allah's existence. Fayu'minu al-'abdu, the slave believes, bi'annahu mawjudun, that Allah is mawjood. Second is ma'rifatu rububiyyatihi, knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is rububiyyah. Knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, His rububiyyah. Fayu'minu al-abdu, the slave believes, bi'annahu rabbu kulli shay'in. Fayu'minu al-abdu, the slave believes, بِأَنَّهُ رَبُّ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ, that Allah is the Lord of everything. الرُّبُوبِيَّة, three things fall under it. خَالِقُ الرَّازِقَ الْمُدَبِّرِ, He's the Khaliq, He's the one who provides for it. Or the Creator, sorry. The Mudabbir, the Provider, or the Sustainer, sorry. And He's the Malik, the King. Those are the three that it revolves around. The third one is, the amount that is obligatory for everybody to know about Allah is ma'rifatu uluhiyyatihi, knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's uluhiyya. And that means that you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fayu'minu al-abdu, the slave believes, bi'annahu huwa alladhi yu'badu bihaqqin wahdahu. Ma'rifatu uluhiyyatihi means what? Fayu'minu al-abdu, the slave believes, بِأَنَّهُ, that Allah تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى هُوَ الَّذِي يُعْبَدُ, He is the one who is worshipped, بِحَقٍ وَحْدَهُ, He is the one that is worshipped alone. وَرَابِعُهَا, the fourth one, is مَعْرِفَةُ أَسْمَائِهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ, knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has names and attributes. فَيُؤْمِنُ الْعَبْدُ بِأَنَّ لِلَّهِ أَسْمَاءً فَيُؤْمِنُ الْعَبْدُ بِأَنَّ لِلَّهِ أَسْمَاءً حُسْنَى وَصِفَاتٍ عُلَى. That the slave believes, فَيُؤْمِنُ الْعَبْدُ بِأَنَّ لِلَّهِ أَسْمَاءً حُسْنَى. That the slave believes Allah has noble names. وَصِفَاتٍ عُلَى. And Allah has majestic characteristics. The statement of the author, وَكُلُّ مَا سِوَى اللَّهِ عَالَمٌ. And anything besides Allah is an alam. He's trying to do tafsir of قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And this statement of the author, which he says, وَكُلُّ مَنْ سِوَى اللَّهِ عَالَمٌ. And everything besides Allah is an alam. Is a statement that the people who came after Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, they took this from him. And this, to be honest, the reality of it is that this has no place in the statements of the Arabs. That the Arabs don't use alam to mean everything besides Allah. That they ever use the word alamina to be like that. The reason like in this came about is those who are known as ulama ilm al-kalam, those who go into philosophy and ilm al-kalam, they place two premises, two muqaddimataini, two principles, two premises, introductions they put in place. The first one is Allah is qadim, Allah is old. And then the second premise is what? Al-alamu hadithun. And this universe is what? It's a starting point. This universe has a starting point, and Allah is old. Those are the two muqaddima they put in place. So what did they say? Everything other than Allah is an alam. So this is a natija aqliya. This is, as it's known, it's a result of their rationality and how they think. لا مدخل لها. And it has no place in the what? في لسان العرب. In the Arabic language. That it means this. The truth of the matter is that everything that exists other than Allah, two types. فالموجودات سوى الله نوعان. The things that exist, فالموجودات سوى الله, the things that exist besides Allah are two types. Does this author's statement, it doesn't show that there's difference between. So we're talking about things other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The things that exist other than Allah. The first one is أفراد التي لا نظير لها من جنسها. They are things that have no duplicate. They have nothing like it. أفراد التي لا نظير لها من جنسها. They have no duplicate in its essence. There's nothing like it in its essence. There's no second thing like that. It's just one and it's alone. فلا يشاركها غيرها في حقيقتها كالكرسي والعرش والجنة والنار. Like the kursi, Allah's throne, Allah's kursi is where Allah places His foot. والعرش is the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والجنة والنار. There's no two jannas, there's only one jannah. There's no two nar, there's only one nar. There's no two kursi, there's only one. The arsh, there's only one. The second one is al-afrad al-mutajanisa. Al-afrad. The second one is al-afrad al-mutajanisa, which basically means al-mushtarikatu. Ama al-mushtarakatu fi jinsin wahidin. They share the same essence. Are you with me, brothers? That's the one that is known as alameen. The Arabs use that one as alameen. And that's like us. We all have the same essence. Also the jinn enter this as well. The angels, they enter this as well. Are you with me, brothers, now? Saying that وَكُلُّ مَا سِوَى اللَّهِ عَالَمٌ. Are you with me, brothers? The Arabs use it for the second one, not the first one. Then the author, rahimahullah, he mentions, فَإِذَا قِيلَ لَكَ, if it is said to you, بِمَا عَرَفْتَ رَبَّكَ, how do you recognize your Lord? How do you recognize your Lord? The Shaykh mentions the dalil, pay attention, for knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and recognizing Him is two. The author gives two, and he guides you to two ways to recognize Allah. Ahaduhuma, the first of the two, is at-tafakkur, pondering fi ayatihi al-kawniyyah, pondering in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's universal signs. And the second one is, you want to know Allah? Do you want to know Him? What's the tariqah for it? You have to attain four things, remember. How can I attain those four things? The first one that the author mentions is at-tafakkur fi ayatihi al-kawniyyah, pondering on Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's universal signs. Looking at the world and how it's made. A lot of the times, the arguments that are used against atheists, the fine-tuning of this universe and how it's fine-tuned, this is ayatul kawniyyah, the universal signs. The second one is at-tadabbur fi ayatihi al-shar'iyyah. The second one is pondering, at-tadabbur, to ponder, fi ayatihi al-shar'iyyah, in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, His Quran, the verses of the Quran. If you look at the author here, rahimahullah, what did he do? He said, ayatihi wa makhluqatihi. Is there a difference between ayatihi wa makhluqatihi? The scholars, they took two stances regarding this. Some scholars, they said this is atful khasi ala al-ammi. Some scholars, they said this is what? Atful khasi ala al-ammi. And that's something that the Arabs generally do, which is they take a specific from a general. They take a specific out of a general and they connect that specific to the general. And we bring many examples of that. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in is atful khasi ala al-ammi. Because isti'ana is what? It's part of ibadah. Is it not? Isti'ana, seeking help and aid from Allah, is that not ibadah? That is ibadah. So you took the khas out of the am. قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ عَدُوًا لِلَّهِ وَجِبْرِيلَ وَمِيكَالَ. Allah says, وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَجِبْرِيلَ وَمِيكَالَ. Jibreel and Mikael were taken out of the angels. This is called عَطْفُ الْخَاسِ عَلَى الْعَامِ. It happens many places in the Quran. Are you with me? The reason why many of the times that is done is لِأَهْمِيَّتِهَا. The ones that are taken out of there are done because of its importance. Also, the hadith is very common. Hadith of Jibreel, hadith of niyyah. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى فَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ لِدُنْيَا يُصِيبُهَا أَوْ امْرَأَةٍ يَنْكِحُهَا. Isn't a woman part of the dunya? Is she not? She is. Why is she taken out of the dunya? It's because of the fitna that the dunya has to men. The women are equal in that fitna as well. Are you with me? Also the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, he said, مَا تَرَكْتُ فِتْنَةً أَضَرَّ عَلَى الرِّجَالِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ. صح؟ Fitna. So it's equal, the women are equal to the dunya in fitna to the men. Some scholars, they say, what it means is that the woman is the ultimate goal for men. And he only uses the dunya to get the woman. Whereas the woman is the opposite. The dunya is what she likes. And the woman, the man is the stepping stone. So, ya Yunus. Some scholars, they said that. That's why women, they like, what do they like? Flashy stuff. Are you with me? If the brother's back pocket is not swollen, he's in trouble, brother. Sah? His back pocket has to be swollen in order for even a meeting to be placed between him and his father. Sah? Are you with me? Now the dowries are becoming serious. Sister might say, as it goes on, huh? I'm going to put myself on a weighing machine. You have to pay that much gold. Yeah. Naam. So the author, why did he distinct? Why did he break this, the two from the two? Some scholars, they said, Atful khasi ala al-ami. Other scholars, they said, no, it's not. The Qur'an slightly used them differently. It used it differently. And he will bring them, the verses, if you look at the examples, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he spoke about the day and the night, the sun and the moon, Allah used the word ayat. When Allah spoke about as-samawat as-sab'a and the aradheen as-sab'a, Allah used makhlukat. And the author is trying to observe the usage of the Qur'an. Are you with me? Then the author, rahimahullah, he brought three verses. He brought how many verses? The author brought here three verses. قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, the statement of Allah, لَخَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَكْبَرُ مِنْ خَلْقِ النَّاسِ. That's the first evidence he brought. And that, brothers, shows that the creating of the samawat and the ard is bigger than the creating of the human being. The human is nothing compared to the samawat and the ard. The second is, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارُ وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ لا تسجدوا للشمس ولا للقمر واسجدوا لله الذي خلقهن إن كنتم إياه تعبدون. And the third verse that he brings is what? The third verse he brings is إن ربكم الله الذي خلق السماوات إن ربكم الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام ثم استوى على العرش. Until the ending of that verse. And then the verse mentions in it, Allah mentions yughshi. The word yughshi means a yughatti, is to cover something. Hathithan means sari'an. Hathith means sari', when something goes fast. Musakharatin means mudallalatin. Allah made this earth dhalil, humiliated for you. You can just walk on it. You put your foot on it. You jump on it. Musakharat means when something is made easy for you, in it's working for you. Allah humiliated his world for you, that it serves your need. And then you go and you worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the author rahimahullah explained and expanded that أَنَّ الرَّبَّ هُوَ الْمُسْتَحِقُ لِلْعِبَادَةِ. The Lord of all of that is the one who deserves to be worshipped. And that's why he says وَالرَّبُّ هُوَ الْمَعْبُودُ. Al-Rabbu, Allah is the one who deserves to be worshipped, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he brings the ayah for it. Ya ayyuha al-nasu u'budu rabbakum. U'budu is what? Worship. We mentioned yesterday, when you open the Mus'haf today, and you read the Qur'an, Surah Al-Fatiha, the first amr that comes in the Qur'an from is اعبدوا ربكم. There's no amr before that. That is the first amr. اعبدوا ربكم. And that is to show you how serious and how important it is that one knows the importance of ibadah. Then the author brings the statement of who? Ibn Kathir rahimahullah. Ibn Kathir is the great scholar who commented on the Quran. He's got a tafsir book. He said in that tafsir of the ayah, Ya ayyuhan nas u'budu rabbakum, in that ayah, he says, Al khaliqu li hadhihi al ashya, the creator of all of this, huwa al mustahiqu lil ibadah, is the one who deserves to be worshipped. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab alone is an imam. And he's alone a scholar. He could extract that ruling by himself. Why does he have to attribute it to Ibn Kathir for? It shows you that the scholars, they quote the scholars. And they attribute things to those who preceded them in it. He could have just said that sentence by himself. And he could have left it there. But what did he choose to do? Attribute to one of the a'imma of this field. Allah subhanahu, sorry, Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala. Damn.